In the name of the one who was, and is to come. Amen. Things take the time they take. Don't worry. How many roads did St. Augustine follow before he became St. Augustine? I'm always arrested by Mary Oliver's elegant way of getting to the point. Those are her poetic words, drawing our attention to that truth along the path we are traveling. In this instance, on our way to holiness, which always takes time. All Saints' Day that we observe today at St. Paul's lifts up the extraordinary witnesses in this world, like Oliver herself. People who show us God's power to consecrate ordinary human beings for greater purposes than we ever could dare to dream for ourselves. However saintly we might believe ourselves to be, or not, this is the day we celebrate God's life alive in each of us. Oliver insists in her poems that we do not have to be good to be counted faithful. All it requires is to let love have its way in us, which takes the time it takes, like she said. Loving what we love, turning toward the source and object of all our loves, which is what St. Augustine said is God, love itself, this is our life's work. And it takes the time it takes, which sometimes seems like no time at all. Loving, letting love carry you where you are meant to go, it's the whole point. Whether you're asking Oliver or Augustine. Today of all days, I think it helps for us to name that plainly, not just jam it poetically between pieces of scripture or sandwich it into those lyrics that will roll around our mouths this morning, because God is always wanting to whisk us away. If not sweeping us off our feet, then at very least spinning us around, setting us down onto the path of freedom and joy. This fellowship we know in the body of Christ invites our deepest gratitude to flow freely as we rejoice in God's great love for us. This is also the day where we gather in our financial pledges for the year ahead. I heard someone joking a couple weeks ago about stewardship experiences they had had in another place and time. This person remarked that this kind of day can sometimes seem like Shakedown Sunday. That is not what we're going for today, I assure you. I like to think about it, though. As all of our readings alluded to, whether you heard it in the psalm or in the gospel, that's a bit of a leaping for joy. Maybe you won't actually do cartwheels unless you walk your pledge down the aisle and place it in these plates that we put out for this purpose each and every year, but maybe you could imagine it as part of a metaphorical dance party. A little less Mary Jane Blige, a bit more Pharrell Williams. If you saw Despicable Me 2, you know what I'm talking about. Devoting ourselves to God's purposes should feel every bit as energizing as a magnificent dance party. We are giving thanks for this amazing love that we have come to know in Christ, a holy love that expands our hearts and magnifies our joy. No matter how much time, talent, or earthly treasure we put in the plate to sustain the ministries of this church, the point is not the particular amount. The point is to not miss out on participating. This is a communal labor of love, and all our lives, our loves, our labors, these are precious gifts that multiply grace whenever we are lucky to share them. This multiplication power should set our souls to dancing. And I ain't just talking about St. Paul's finance team or the vestry. Our text from Ephesians talks about this in that phrase, the pledge of our inheritance. This is an unshakable promise that God has made to us God's glory in compelling ways in the world. And today is a day for discovery, if you didn't know that was your calling. It's also a day for celebration, because that seal of the Holy Spirit placed upon our forehead in baptism is meant for each and every one of us. If you've been around any of the rooms at St. Paul's this fall, especially conversations we've been having in the month of October, then you might have been part of that conversation about what it looks like to lean intentionally into these gifts that we are given in baptism, raised to this new life of grace that reveals Christ's risen life in us. And if you've been part of those conversations we've had on Sunday mornings, talking about these gifts as celebration, courage, and curiosity, then you probably know that I believe God means our entire existence, yours, mine, ours, all of it is meant to radiate divine goodness. That prayer in our baptismal liturgy talks about how we are meant to be blessed, to be a blessing, our lives enhanced with this capacity to be people of curiosity, courage, joy, and wonder, people who celebrate all God's works in the world. I believe these gifts strengthen us to share love generously, just like God loves us. Our whole selves, when we arrive on the planet, come wired to stretch toward this fullness, and in this spiritual community, we discover that we can't fully be who God intends us to be, who God created us to be, without the loving support and gracious presence of others who are making this journey together in faith. Now, I know we're really excited for some of the newest, youngest choir members to be part of this morning's worship service, and we're going to sing that really lovely song, and you guys are going to help lead us in it, where we talk about saintly living and what it looks like, that witness that we see in people who God's love has made strong, people like doctors selflessly serving their public and patients, teachers and train conductors greeting pupils and passengers with patience and kindness, in the faithful duties of a gracious queen across the pond who has gone home to meet her maker, and all who shepherd the vulnerable, whatever the pasture. Yes, this song reminds us that even if sainthood wasn't on that top list of our hashtag life goals, we are put here on the planet to live into God's dreams of what we can be together as we listen, serve, love, pray, and praise in ways that reveal Christ crucified and risen. Which brings us back to those Pulitzer Prize-winning ways and winsome words of Mary Oliver, who, interestingly enough, did not profess to be a Christian, but who witnessed well and graciously to the light of love ever redeeming the world. Oliver was someone who died at the end of 2019. And we might have missed that because, you know, there was something kicking up at the beginning of 2020, something that has occupied our attention for a while. Oliver was a confirmed smoker who defied lung cancer for a few decades. And even if we missed her death in the midst of the onset of COVID, it's a witness to the reality that not even death can defeat the power of life alive in us, the life of God daring us every moment to decide what we will do with our wild and precious lives. Even if that isn't your favorite Mary Oliver line, I believe that does call the question that we do well to consider this day, especially when we take in mind the gospel's challenge in the Beatitudes, challenges that remind us that this life needs to lead to the flourishing of all people. So there are concerns of justice and equity that factor in and are intricately bound up with that joy that Jesus bears witness to in the Beatitudes. Those provocative wake-up calls that frame our choice and sharpen the question about how we will steward blessings God entrusts to us in this life. poetic words. Oliver says, "I know you never intended to be in this world, but you're in it all the same. So why not get started immediately? I mean, belonging to it. There's so much to admire, to weep over, and to write music or poems about. Bless the feet that take you to and fro. Bless the eyes and the listening ears. Bless the tongue, the marvel of taste. Bless touching. You could live 100 years. It's happened. Or not. I am speaking from the fortunate platform of many years, none of which I think I ever wasted. Do you need a prod? Do you need a little darkness to get you going? Let me be urgent as a knife then and remind you of Keats. So single of purpose and thinking for a while, he had a lifetime." Oliver sure knows how to pack a punch. Yes, we are gifted with just one lifetime. Blessed to walk together on this journey of faith. So as we give thanks today for the pledge of our inheritance, that precious seal of the Holy Spirit placed upon us in baptism, let's listen to all those audacious voices of love that challenge us to embrace love's promise. It takes the time it takes, and it doesn't have to take so long at all, to surrender to the magic of this divine life we share in Christ. There's never been a better time for rejoicing. And it's going to be one heck of a dance party. Amen.